I know, it's fun putting this little day up.
You're decorating on Monday.
Okay.
That's Monday.
I don't need an art painting on Friday.
Yeah.
To make sure.
This side.
Doesn't it look nice, it's all decorated, we all did a good job, Frank?
No.
No, it didn't work, I did not go there until I went to view it at home, like a. Yeah, they had issues with the modem.
Like Zenius.
I thought they were changing the modem.
Yeah, it went from.
I don't know who else brought it, and they saw it.
Was it there? Some other. I know they were talking about.
I know in town, it's definitely.
I didn't really get the plot, just the player.
And I know.
Oh, yes.
I hope that's a shift.
So what you're doing.
Yeah.
So, and I guess. I'm not going on that. That's good. I guess when I retire.
Good morning, the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Well, it's good to be here in the house of the Lord to worship him and thank him for his love, for his mercy, for everything that he gave us without any merit on our part. So today is the first Sunday in Advent, and we begin our journey to our Christmas. We celebrate the Nativity of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. A few announcements before we begin. First, thanks Gregory for praying for us this morning. God bless you. And as well, we have a visitor, Anna, is with us. So God bless you, and you are always welcome.
Well, thank you.
And worship with us. Wonderful. A few announcements before we begin our service. Remember that we have our, this is called Congregation at Prayer and Devotion for the Week. We have it on the table over there, and then we could use it for devotion for the week, if you would like to take it. As well, we have the devotion for Advent. We put it in the back on the table, so you could take one. And regarding other announcements, Christmas services are great. Christmas Eve service here will be at 5 p.m. on Friday, December 24th. And we are planning to have Christmas Day service here at 9 a.m. And for sure, then Sunday on the 26th. But unless you don't want to have Christmas Day here, and we have only Christmas Eve, and then we have on Sunday. What do you say? And we could follow if you would like. I am okay to come, no problem. But we could follow the service live streaming from Faith at 11, if you prefer.
So you decided to have Christmas Day service here? I know it was going to be an issue.
Yes, I just want to ask your opinion because we want to hear you. I want to hear you. What, for me, it's okay to come Christmas Day. But if you think what be better, okay, to, because we have on Friday, Christmas Eve, and then Saturday, and then Sunday. So if we skip the Christmas Day and we go directly to Sunday with Holy Communion, and that can be done as well. So I want to hear your opinion. I don't want to take this decision because Christmas time is a very important time for everybody.
Maybe we should take a vote.
Well, who's in favor of having them Christmas Day service, even though we only have one pastor, he's busy, he has three services on Christmas Eve, and then three services on Sunday, which is 2 days later.
Yes, I have Christmas Eve, I have a 5 o'clock here service, and then two services at 8, at 7 and at 9.
Yeah. And you're still going to have Christmas Day service at Faith?
Yes, at 11. At 11. But if you think that better we skip Christmas Day on Saturday and we have it on Sunday, the service, you could follow the service, Christmas Day service, from Faith at 11, live stream. That can be done.
Yeah, we can do that.
And in that case, also, we're just going to be there at 11, leading the service. And then on Sunday, we are here at 9 a.m. And then at 11, at the three. Okay, are those who are in favor of not having Christmas Day service and we follow the service from Faith at 11, please raise your hand. Okay, so we are going to follow the Christmas Day service from Faith at 11.
Yeah.
But we have Christmas Eve at 5 p.m. and on Sunday at 9 a.m. Okay, so I will change the announcements in the bulletin for next Sunday. Other announcements. Take the take the bulletin with you. There are more announcements about the activities for that week, and you could see for yourself. Remember that we have office hours here at Grace at 2 p.m. Anything, you could call me here or visit me and we talk and etc. So I am always available, and at Faith, when I am at Faith as well, I am available. Remember, food bank. So we are, I didn't put it in the bulletin, many things I forgot, sorry about that. But we are collecting things, items for the food bank. So bring it every Sunday or during the week on Thursday, for example, and we're gonna, well, actually it's over there. And so I thought that was there, but suddenly it's there. I don't know. Anyway, so bring items for the food bank. So we always do that every year. And what? Oh, calendar. Calendar of December are over there. So you could take a calendar for December's activities. And in that case, you have to ignore Christmas Day, okay? So here anyway, so. Voters meeting. Remember voters meeting next Sunday at Faith? We're gonna approve the budget for the next year and as well the new officers of the council. It's very important that we come and go and see what we are talking about, things that concern not only our faith but as well our grace. So it's very important that if you are able to come. Anyway, so that's it. Please rise and let us begin with a service prayer. We begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We continue at this moment with the lining of the Advent wreath. We sing, O come, Emmanuel, first stanza. Seated, we continue with the hymn Savior of the Nation Comes, in three stanzas. Thank you. rise. We continue with the opening sentences. The Lord says, I will fulfill the promise I made to the houses of Israel and Judah.
We thank you, Lord.
The Lord says, my righteous branch will cause justice and righteousness to spring up.
We adore you, O Lord.
The Lord says, you will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory.
We praise you, O Lord.
The Lord says, heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away.
We worship you, O Lord.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, having emerged from the waters of baptism as God's new creation in Christ, we confess our sins to God and one another. A time of silence is observed. We confess to you, O Lord, that we are captive to sin in thought, word, and deed. We have neither loved you with our whole heart, nor loved our neighbors as ourselves.
Remember your mercy, O Lord, and your steadfast love, for they have been from of old.
Remember not the sins of my youth or my transgressions.
According to your steadfast love, remember me for the sake of your goodness, O Lord.
Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for you, and for his sake forgives you all your sins. As a called and ordained servant of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore forgive you all your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We continue with the introit, and we speak it responsibly. Behold, your King is coming to you, righteous and having salvation.
Who in the skies can be compared to the Lord? Who among the heavenly beings is like the Lord?
Righteousness and justice are the foundation of your throne. The steadfast love and faithfulness go before you.
Blessed are the people who know the festal shepherd, who walk, O Lord, in the light of your face,
who exalt your name all the day, and in your righteousness are exalted.
For our shield belongs to the Lord, our King to the Holy One of Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Behold, your King is coming to you, righteous and having salvation.
Lord, have mercy on us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Stir up your power, O Lord, and come, that by your protection
we may be rescued from the threatening perils of our sins,
and saved by your mighty deliverance.
For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
You may be seated. Let us hear God's word.
Old Testament reading. The prophet Jeremiah foresees a day when God would come to bring righteousness to his people. Jeremiah 33:14-16. Behold, the days are coming, declares the Lord, when I will fulfill the promise I made to the house of Israel and the house of Judah. In those days and at that time, I will cause a righteous branch to spring up from David, and he shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. In those days Judah will be saved, and Jerusalem will dwell securely. And this is the name by which I will be called. The Lord is our righteousness. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The epistle is from 1 Thessalonians 3, 9 to 13. Paul reminds us that God can cause us to abound in love for one another as we await the coming of the Lord. What thanksgiving can we return to God for you, for all the joy that we feel for your sake before our God, as we pray most earnestly night and day that we may see your face to face and supply what is lacking in your faith. Now may our God and Father himself and our Lord Jesus direct our way to you, and may the Lord make you increase and abound in love for one another and for all, as we do for you, so that he may establish your hearts blameless in holiness before our God and Father at the coming of our Lord Jesus with all his saints. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Let's pray.
Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the 21st chapter.
Glory be to you, Lord.
The kingdom of God is near. Please rise. Jesus said, there will be signs in sun and moon and stars, and on the earth distress of nations in perplexity because of the roaring of the sea and the waves. People fainting with fear and with foreboding of what is coming on the world. For the powers of the heavens will be shaken, and then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. Now, when these things begin to take place, strengthen up and raise your heads, because your redemption is drawing near. And he told them a parable. Look at the fig tree and all the trees. As soon as they come out in leaf, you see for yourself and know that the summer is already near. So also, when you see these things taking place, you know that the kingdom of God is near. Truly I say to you, this generation will not pass away until all has taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But watch yourself, lest your hearts be weighed down with dissipation and drunkenness and cares of this life, and that day come upon you suddenly like a trap. For it will come upon all who dwell on the face of the whole earth. But stay awake at all times, praying you may have the strength to escape all these things that are going to take place, and to stand before the Son of Man. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Christ.
We confess our Christian faith, speaking the Apostle's Creed. I believe
in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, the life everlasting. Amen.
You may be seated. We continue with two stanzas from hymn 331, The Advent of Our King.
Thank you.
friends in Christ, our meditation for this morning is from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 21, verses 34 to 36. I read it a while ago, but let us repeat it one more time. Let us hear it one more time. But watch yourself, lest your heart be weighed down with dissipation and drunkenness and cares of this life. And that day come upon you suddenly like a trap. For it will come upon all who dwell on the face of the whole earth. But stay awake at all times, praying that you may have strength to escape all these things that are going to take place, and to stand before the Son of Man. Here ends the text for our meditation. Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father, and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Friends, Advent begins on the Sunday closest to St. Andrew's Day, which is Tuesday. Until December 17, Advent focuses on last things, when Jesus shall return. Then we focus on his first coming, Christmas. A new church year proclaims a new start, and today's gospel gives us a sharp warning against ungodly living while giving rich promises to believers. Faith is not troubled by the coming destruction of the world. Believers look forward to it. Yet all believers have a sinful nature that can be tempted and trapped by scattered schedules, indulgences, and anxiety. Believers live in the not yet of heaven. What I mean is that we live by grace. We are saved, but we are not yet in heaven. We are called to get ready now for his return, which is not yet. Advent is not about stirring up holiday goodies, decorating homes, or even getting hearts ready to celebrate Christmas. It is about the return of Jesus. So the question is, are you ready? On this first day of Advent, we remember his threefold coming. He was the one to come, the one who will return, and present now. We know Christ was the one to come. God inspired the prophets to proclaim his first coming, such as today's Old Testament reading, Jeremiah's righteous branch. There are over 300 direct prophecies for Jesus. God inspired the apostles to proclaim and write that the Christ did come. Jesus fulfilled the prophecies of the Old Testament like no other man could. Most importantly, he redeemed us incompletely by his cross. We can sing or speak the Advent introit in a past tense. Behold, our King has come, righteous and having salvation. This is the message of the Christian church. We preach that the only Messiah did come as promised, and all of God's promises are true. We preach Christ and him crucified. Friends, many of you have computers. You know what happens when you hit the delete key. Those people who are super tech in computers can usually recover those files, sometimes even weeks later. God promises in Jesus' name that your sins are not just deleted. They are wiped out completely. It can never be recovered. This is the gospel, the good news. Jesus died for all sins of all time. We know Christ is the one who will return, exactly as described. For every word he says is true. He will come with great power and glory, without warning. Many, even some bearing the name Christians, will be trapped unexpectedly. Friends, do you have mice in your houses? I hope you do not have. Here at church, we have those rodents. Peanut butter works great in trapping them. Boom! They never knew what hit them. You, my fellow believers, can be caught by Satan in a similar way. Satan does not use peanut butter. Like a carrot on a stick, he dangles what you desire right before your eyes and leads you where he wants. Maybe you want a relationship so bad. Satan leads you to go against the commandments so you get what he wants. Maybe you want money. Satan will show you which corners to cut. It may you want more. Or maybe he wants you to gossip and become a false witness for Jesus. Our Lord Jesus warns us to be cautious. Satan wants to weigh down hearts. Dissipation. Wow. Does that sound like this time of year? Do you feel pulled in a dozen direction at once? Focus on today's crisis. Or do you squander energy and time on what feels good? Satan loves that trap, dissipation. Drunkenness is not only alcohol. The simple truth is that what has happened throughout the modern world is that Christians have been weighed down with dissipation and drunkenness and the worries of life. Dissipation is wasting your life on things of no significance or value. We probably prefer to think of it as living like an alcoholic, just drinking and wasting life on a grand scale. But dissipation actually is any pursuit that has not real value. Another thing that distracts many Christians is the worries of life. That is what weighs most of us down. We worry about all sorts of things. The next paycheck. Or we worry about the weather. Or we worry about the pandemic. Or we worry about the political situation in our country. Or we worry about the economy. Or we worry about our health. Life is every day, and its dangers, threats, worries, and fears are always clamoring for our attention. Which ones have your attention? Jesus warns that your heart will be trapped, and you will not be ready for his return. You may be ready to celebrate a worldly Christmas, but not his return. Jesus says, be careful. How do we do that? Jesus gives the answer. Be always watching. For what? For the traps he mentions. Rather than remaining dissipated, begin your day with a good Christmas hymn. and devotion focused on Christ crucified for you. Rather than being intoxicated by the feelings, sights, foods, sounds, and the rest of this fallen world, sober yourself by remembering that God will destroy all this in an instant at Christ's return. God gave us all these things to use for the kingdom and our good. What else does Jesus say? Pray. Both that you will be spared the brunt of terrors and that you will be able to stand in the judgment. That is, that your faith is based in the grace of the Lord, our righteousness, when Jesus comes with all his holy ones. Hold on to your precious faith. Jesus will come to complete the history of the world, closing the book of life to all unbelievers, but granting you an open door to heaven in the cross. That's why Jesus says, watch and be ready for the end. So how does God strengthen our hearts so that we will be blameless and holy? Here, our epistle of today tells us something about that. By coming in word and sacraments, we know Christ is the one who keeps coming. He comes in his word, the Holy Scriptures. Faith comes by hearing, in study, liturgy, sermons, devotions. God's word warns us, turn in faith before grace ends. Turn away from turning every direction but Christ. God's word also comes to calm our hearts in the forgiving power of Jesus Christ. His promises of life and salvation in the name of Jesus are true. He gives you the forgiveness and also the power to forgive. If there is someone you have been angry at for a long time, think about the meaning of Christmas and sit down and write them a Christmas card. God has forgiven them all their sins. That's why Jesus came. Jesus warned about anxiety. Now, I am not talking about depression, anxiety attacks, or clinical condition, but weekly worries or holiday fears. Trust that God can get you through. That's his promise to you. Drench yourself in his promises of life and salvation. He comes to you in his holy word. Heaven and earth will pass away, but his promises will never pass away. He also comes to us in the means of grace, baptism, and Holy Communion. To conclude, my friends in Christ, one day Jesus will return in great glory, and heaven and earth will pass away, but God's word shall remain forever. Jesus tells us that that day is coming, and it will come upon everyone who lives on this planet. The temptations will be to fall up in fear, panic into unbelief, or to surrender your expectation that the day of the Lord will come soon, and to get busy living like everyone else in this world. That is why you are called to watch and pray. Keep in your minds and hearts the following. The battle for your salvation has already been fought. Jesus fought it on the cross and rose from the grave to declare the victory. Your sins have been forgiven. Jesus has poured out on you the gift of everlasting life and resurrection from your grave. That is, if the world does not end before your body goes to the grave. He poured those gifts out on you in your baptism, and he feeds you with his body and blood each time we have it for the strengthening of your faith and to regularly cleanse you of your sins. The one thing we want to be sure to do is to stand firm, that is, to be faithful. To do that, we need to watch and see in the world around us, particularly in the things that cause fear and trembling among men, the promised signals of our Heavenly Father, intended to remind us of the truth and refocus us on the task at hand, and comfort us by showing his faithfulness and the certainty of the end. We want to strengthen up and lift up our heads and look for our salvation to come, thereby clearly confessing Jesus Christ. We do that standing up and lifting up our heads by prayers, calling on him to continue to complete his work in us, and that he may accomplish through us all that he has planned. Mostly, we want to deliberately and consciously trust God, because he that believes and is baptized shall be saved. And in order to accomplish all of that, we need to do as Jesus said, watch and pray. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please rise, we continue with prayers. As we prepare our hearts and minds for Christ's coming, we turn to the Lord in prayer. O wisdom from high, guide your church throughout the world to be a demonstration of hope. Move the leaders, pastors, teachers, and all the people of our synod to yearn for that coming day when Jesus will reign forever in justice and righteousness, and all creation will be restored. We pray.
Hear us, coming Lord.
O desire of nations, bless the leaders of nations, our prime minister and leaders of the parliament, our governor general, and other local leaders. Move all leaders to cease envy and boastfulness, injustice and corruption. Guide our leaders to be honorable people who do not neglect the poor and who strive toward the flourishing of all human beings, and work for all the citizens of this nation without discrimination. Bless those who serve in our armed forces, and lift up refugees and all victims of war. Bring peace between us and our enemies, and let your peace reign over this broken world. We pray.
Hear us, coming Lord.
O day spring from on high, come to the aid of all who are in need. As you humbly enter this world as a vulnerable baby, help all of us to enter humbly the lives of those who are sick, facing surgery, recuperating from surgery, or dying, to offer comfort and hope. Especially, we remember this day Cassie, or Annette, wife of Pastor Ward, for Sandy, who's recuperated from surgery, for Susan, for Anne and Mike, for Rainer and Marianne, for Ritva, for Marcus and Risto, for Lisette and family, and for Geraldine.
and for members of Faith Church in London who are going through the same trials and tribulation and need healing. Also, we pray for those we name in our hearts and minds. Bring healing according to your will and peace to those who suffer and endure. Thank you for the work of doctors, nurses, and other medical professionals who work toward healing and restoration of wholeness. Guide scientists searching for cures for diseases that bring suffering to the world, that their work might lead to healing for many. We pray.
Hear us,
O King of David, let your joy, forgiveness, and peace flow freely in and among the families of this congregation. Especially we remember Michelle. We remember Howard, Jennifer, Sheldon, McKenna, and Mike. We remember Nick and Lori Sue. And we remember Lunda. Empower parents and grandparents to love their children and children to love their parents. Watch over all who travel and comfort families who are separated by many miles. Guide families to be places where your love is demonstrated to strangers as well as to friends. We pray.
Hear us, Lord.
O Lord, protect those members in our congregation who celebrate their birthdays this week. Especially we remember Myra. Look with favor on her and continuous blessing her each day of her life, and keep her safe from all harm and danger. We pray, hear us, coming Lord. Lord of mercy, we pray for this congregation, that giving thanks for all of God's blessings to us, we may live peaceful and quiet lives, godly and dignified in every way. And we continue confessing Jesus our Savior and bring the good news of our salvation to others. We pray,
hear us,
Lord. O Lord of might, help us during this Advent season, both to look back to those days when our salvation was won in your death and resurrection, and to look forward to the day of your return, when by your power you will bring the dead to life and restore all creation. We pray,
hear us, Lord.
You, O Lord, know the thoughts of our hearts and hear those prayers that come to you in sighs too deep for words. All our prayer we entrust to you in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
May the Lord make you increase and abound in love for one another and for all, so that he may establish your hearts blameless in holiness before our God and Father at the coming of our Lord Jesus with all his saints. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Amen.
Amen.
For closing him, the King shall come with morning dawn.
Thank you.
conclude our worship service this morning, our first Sunday of Advent. God bless you and thanks all those as well who helped in decorating the church. Those who came, and that was wonderful. Looked beautiful. I like to come here and live here instead. Because you keep it nicely. Thank you. Have a blessed day. Go out and serve the Lord.
So our baby turned 40 yesterday. Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
That's probably the only reason why I'm on the list.
Okay, well, that's my
So we went there for something last night.
I'm going to get pummeled by a banner.
Left?
Yeah.
So as I was saying, I lost her.
So did poor Beethoven get a good funeral?
Just her here. So I said to her, like,
do you smell mouse?
No, I don't. Thankfully.
He actually said that it looks like he's been kind of chewing at this a little bit.
So how did you meet this mom?
Well, Joanna set us up because she knows him through Danielle, her sister.
Yeah.
And she's like,
I don't know any young, I don't know any guys that might be, and I'm like, okay, and she's like, I know this guy, and I'm like, okay, she's like, she actually set up our first meeting, she did too, it was actually quite humorous how Joanna's like, okay, so you guys are gonna go meet her at the memorial park there in Liston. Because that's kind of about halfway, right?
And she's like, make sure you dress up nice, this is a date.
I'm like, okay, mom. Which is funny because like Joanna's like 7 years younger than me.
Yeah. And then we met, and it was cold. But we had a lunch.
She impressed early and often. Like she came with a full lunch.
You know how to make that soup with people? Oh, you betcha. That's his favorite. I definitely know my own. That came up in conversation last night with the Bible study. Because that's what I brought for James. My maiden last name is French. I married a Beattie.
My dad is a John Beattie, actually. Where are you from?
No, he's from Alberta.
Okay, because we do one here.
Yeah, it's very popular. But my Oma's name was Gearling, with an H, not a G, but you say it, right?
Gearling.
And you had Gearling through Mary in Kloppenhauer.
Really?
Not a Mr. Wall. Yeah. That might be a relation.
The three degrees of Dutch separation here.
Her maiden name is Van Fleet. Yeah. Which that's
how are you?
Yeah. There's lots of
Van Fleet and
looks pretty good now.
So that's in the family. But my dad's maiden name was
that looks pretty straight now, Franco.
Yeah. Which is actually Irish and Scottish.
At least it's straight with the lines on the wall here.
I warned him already. I said to him, I'm Dutch and I'm Irish and Scottish. So I can get you a really good bargain. I can make really good food.
And you got a 10-year-old of bills.
Sheep, I don't know, red hair.
You have red hair?
Yeah.
It's whole family.
We're red. It dims a lot, but yeah.
It's mine.
Yeah.
So I wanted a nice red beard.
Yeah, you did. My brother's is like that, actually.
I'm gonna grow mine nice.
Oh yeah, until it gets like
that Jewish book, Jewish book that I read.
And that you read.
Are you gonna do the little? So he'd be out driving a truck, and I'd be
still
like,
have to,
well, if you want to, we can talk. And it would talk
last year for us,
2 hours a night.
Well, he's driving.
You guys know Bill, right?
And so we were getting to know each other better.
Last year, I ran out of sheer bolts one day when I was.
And you're of same faith?
Doing some
deep of Jesus
Christ. Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, I grew up Dutch Reformed. And then.
Christian Reformed?
No, Dutch
Reformed.
Dutch Reformed.
Black stocking church.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
Mexico Bay.
Yes. Yeah. And so when we were raised. Oh, there you go. Yeah. And that's what my mom goes to.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm from Brampton, Georgetown.
Nope.
You gotta do that. That was a nasty job, too. Which one was the guy from the
homes of John? I can't even remember his last name. He had a friend, Henry DeBoer.
The one?
Yep.
He had a white streak through the front of his hair.
Kind of Christmas.
Well, it's all white now.
Oh, isn't that awful?
But anyway, so
yeah,
true.
I'm pretty sure that's
the true young people. That's how we got to see that. Trillium.
Nature is changing, but I mean,
went for a walk and it rained, it was very wet. And then he was like,
when we go for those meetings,
nobody said totally. And so, obviously, and then,
no, it's just
he went home. I got my first talking and everything. I don't know, I've just been like, you guys,
clear cutting the hills and the. The forest doesn't help either because the rain just washes off and creates mud.
If this isn't your will, let me know early, you know?
Yeah.
Basically, it's been going good.
Yeah. And I'm not rushing anything.
Exactly. Yeah. The whole area is Fraser Valley is all nice and flat.
But he's a lovely person.
There's a few little bumps where they
I
made a town.
Been chumming around with him.
And then the other one has issues with dairy, so
and we've had many different cookies.
because I do a lot of ours baby in our family. Ours have been like, what? No, I'll have the blue. Eating it. Yeah, these ones. They need the name butter. Yeah, this is the vegan soy crap, whatever. And he's like, okay.
It is clean.
Ginger ones are good. Okay.
We had this
and our daughter-in-law, she
years
is
ago, we were very contracting. And they
yes.
had some
yeah,
little
issues off of cheese, everything.
Our insurance
our was son so has more issues with this insurance as
we
well.
Any kind of
a lot of it's gluten free. So
and
she's
yes.
really good at
the rules.
Oh,
and,
yeah.
You know,
and some of her kids, they seem to have certain issues, but not as bad as that.
Drywall.
They just go back from 2 weeks hunting and our son got 3 years.
Oh, nice.
And they love doing their hunting. Her parents got a 280 acre sugar bush.
Oh, that's
my awesome. Aunt over there.
Yeah.